MC. Lottie dot, I don't wear Versace. I wear DJs out quickly at the party. Who am I? If you're like me, hip hop is in your body. Who am I? The MC. When the jam is slow,
I hit somebody straight up.
Pushing dope dealing so much.
Man,
and that was your whole thing.
2005. I was at Central. Mm-hmm. Freshman year. Okay. Man, if I tell you anybody else was playing anything but TM101, they mm-hmm. lied.
Listen.
TM101, like, when I say I've never seen, like, one album, like, flood the streets.
Mm-hmm.
Like, if there was a car that was not playing TM101, you was a square. No, that's how.
And you just showed your age by saying the word square. Man. I just want you to know that. Go for ages on blast with that one.
Hey, but black don't crack, so it's
I'm talking about
that. That's what I'm saying. This man ain't got no cracks in this right here. Look at that.
And I thought the female was going to be the vainest one in the room.
You thought wrong, nigga.
He's like bragging by himself.
This nigga so good.
If there are any females that want to do the next episode so we can have some more estrogen in the room, please let me know. Hit the inbox now.
But you know, I just think, for me, man, you know, going back to like just that old school, like even like talk about Pac. Yeah, I discussed with somebody about Pac a couple of days ago. And it's like, oh man, I ain't really get into Pac. But to me, Pac, it wasn't just the music, it's the whole persona.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like when I listen to Pac, man, I just felt that.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I won't deny it.
I'm a straight rider. You don't wanna fuck with me.
You know what I'm saying? That's what old school does.
You know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? You start thinking about that. I want to pour a little liquor for my man, you know? So those kind of songs to me kind of touch me. You know, it's like, oh, yeah, I feel that, you know? And so I think now I don't have that connection.
Mm-hmm.
So when I hear certain songs, it's more about, okay, what the beat sound like, or I might just do like, you know, what kind of lyrics they spit, that kind of thing. It's not a connection emotionally. It's more of a, you know, well, okay, I can
yeah,
do that.
Right, cool beat.
You know, it's cool yeah. beat. I can turn that up a little bit. That kind
of
thing.
I'm gonna tell you, if you don't get my attention within the first 30 seconds of your song,
next. Yeah.
But I'm serious. Okay, so either your beat has to get me,
mm-hmm.
or you have to start having some kind of catch. Not that whole, oh, nonsense, yeah, I hear you that. No, I don't want all that extra ad-libbing on there. It's unnecessary. It's unnecessary.
Turn me up real quick.
I hate that. Why am I turning you up? I'm already on 44. Why? That's unnecessary.
You're
you can edit that out of your whole song. That's unnecessary. Get to the music. Get to the point.
So you pretty much like, yo, just get to it. Like,
yeah.
To it.
Yeah.
I'm like that with your man, too.
Yeah. We're not going to even go there.
Everything,
let's get to it.
Listen, fuck a phone.
Get
you. What you doing, young boy?
Have your kids. Why you hide your kids. Hide your kids now for these next conversations because I'm going to go on the loud. Completely. This is what happens when you get in the room for my guys. Yeah. Going back, I think you said something.
Uh-huh.
About the just the feeling of the emotion,
right?
Can you even equate any new age artist to any emotion?
For me, no. I mean, like I said, no. Walker song, I can get into that emotion as far as like getting hype. You know, I want to work out, that kind of thing. I like a lot of Kendrick stuff though. You know what I'm saying? Because Kendrick stuff kind of make you think. So, and I'm like, I'm an intellectual type person. I love, when you connect with me intellectually, I'm with you. And so like Kendrick kind of connects to me that way.
Right. Hey, you hear the Big Crit?
I heard about it. Okay. I heard about it.
No, yeah. I haven't.
Oh, you haven't heard?
Big Crit tough.
Because he's on some more intellectual shit.
Double it down, I work it around, I'm making it happen. I've been snapping. I've been snapping. What you doing, that ain't rapping. That's how I cap it. Put a cap on it. Luxury tax, my flow. How I get it, you ain't know. You ain't made it, you ain't make it. Nigga, I've been flexing, I've been ripping. I've been doing what I need to do and two-stepping. Mississippi. Daddy worked up on the train. Mama always had brains. She a teacher now. You know it, how we get down. So stop with all them bullshit moves about where I come from, nigga.
And what I like about Crit, because he's kind of, I would say him, J. Cole, Kendrick, are kind of pretty much to me on that,
okay,
on that same group of new age rappers. That's kind of where they'll put out some shit with a dope beat that can catch you for the new school, but they're going to hit you with some like some lyrics for the old school.
Okay.
So to me, I think they're kind of, it's like a good mix of bringing both the old school and new school and kind of hybrid that shit together.
Okay.
So like, that's I fuck with Crit heavy, man. So like, check this shit out, man. Cause you talking about something that you want, something emotional that you can connect to. Cause he's not just gonna add just some shit that not beats. He gonna spit some shit that beat you.
Right,
thinking of shit.
Right.
You feel me? So,
Jay-Z not on intellectual shit, but he's still kind of the same thing with connecting with the old.
Oh, you don't fuck with Jay?
I put it this way, because I'm on the same page with Will. I messed with Jay when it was back, Blueprint, and back. New Jay, no.
DJ Cool Freestyle.
New Jay, no.
I still fuck.
I'm not in the minority. I'm not. For me, it's just like, damn, like, Jig has been like such a, to me, is like kind of one of the pillars of hip hop.
He is.
But to do what?
I still see that nigga's Hawaiian soap. Every time I see him, that's Hawaiian soap, nigga.
Nah, I always think of George Campbell and shit. I know that too. You know, throw some chains on a nigga, that nigga knows. They look just like the cigarette. Hey, every time I look at a cigarette pad, I'm like,
I just
remember that logo for life.
I just want to look at his damn head.
But it's funny because we were talking about something earlier, like. And I was thinking about it, like, Jay-Z is like, you know, like he said, you know, men lie, women lie, numbers don't.
Mm-hmm.
His numbers always been up there.
Right.
Same with Eminem.
Right. So it's DMX.
Yep.
And he don't get the credit that he
deserves. DMX does not get none of the credit.
But what I'm saying is, when their numbers is up there, and they got the money, does that equate to good music?
No.
Because to me, it always don't.
It don't.
Because I still fuck with Jay-Z, but I can still hit skip on this shit. Because this shit is not pumping like
that. No. Right.
No.
You feel me though? It's the same. Okay, like, I don't know if I have a discussion with you, but if we're talking about everybody do their top biggies.
And where the long ass list.
Yeah. That's another thing. Where do you put female rappers in that?
To me, female rappers can go anywhere. As long as you can spit. If you can spit.
Right, but how are you, but how, that goes back to saying it's preference. There was like, I was just watching last night on YouTube, T.I. did a top 50 greatest rap artists. It started, I think, World Star first put it out, whatever else. But the first thing he said was, who came up with this list? Because everybody, your preference is going to be different from my preference. My preference is going to be different from your preference.
people in this room.
Right. My list is probably going to contain more females than y'all list do, because that's it's what somebody relates to. Mm-hmm. You know, my list might have MC Light, it might have Queen, it may have Salt Pepper, but that's a good question. Where do the females add up at? Where are you putting them in there? Where are you going to put someone like Queen Latifah in there? Foxy, Trina, where are you going to put any of them at?
Oh, yeah. My mom, of course. I love her.
Bruh, you can... I wish I had an argument.
Pat going to have something to say about that.
Black love.
Pat going to have something to say about that.
But that's the thing. So, okay, so if everybody had to pick their favorite female artist, as of right now, not equating City Girls, I'm talking about old school female artists. Bluffing stuff with my Afro puffs. Rock on with your man say. I rock bluffing stuff with my Afro puffs. Rock on with your man. I'm a wicked bomb, I'm a naughty nature. I'm living foul like a nigga about to drink. I'm not that woman to sleep, but I'm lost. You must be blind if you don't believe or hear. Listen to this rhyme. Ladies first, take no time to rehearse. I'm divine and my mind expands throughout the universe. A female rapper, praise me not for being simply what I am. Born in L-O-N-D-O and sound American. You dig exactly where I'm. Like, old school? Just old school.
Lil Kim back then was fucking
Lauryn Hill.
Lauryn Hill.
I like, Boss. Okay. Lady Rage.
Okay. Oh, you talking about roughing yourself with your Afro punch?
Going with your bad.
Go ahead with your bad. Hey, just because y'all don't, that's Baby D, you know.
That's
Lady Rage.
I'm
just saying.
No, I don't think a lot of people know that.
I'm just making sure she became mainstream. Her bars on Itty Bitty Piggy.
That alone.
Yeah.
I was at Shaw U when I listened to that song for the first time, and I just put it on repeat for the first minute and a half because that first line was just retarded. Like, you can't. I think once they cross mainstream, then it questions, okay, where was your sound when you were hungry for this? When you were sitting there making pin count pins to make sure you could get in the studio type stuff.
Right. I think that's what it is, though. It's like you knew, undiscovered, home.
That's right.
And so now you try to give you best, you know, you try to spit the best you can. It's like you take boxing. You know what I'm saying? When a boxer young, and he got a box his way up there, he hungry. He try to get to that, so he get that big purse. It's the same thing, man.
Hey, that's why Mayweather's still undefeated. He was just as hungry as he was going 50-0 as he was trying to go 1-9.
But if you gotta keep that, man.
That shoulder that.
What I'm saying?
But
you gotta be hungry, man. You gotta keep that hunger, that drive. I think a lot of times, you get that money, you get that fame.
That's it.
You know, you feel like, then you kind of feel
and
like.
And that
you,
goes back to, so does the money out, change
I can
them?
Put out, yeah. I can put out whatever, people gonna buy it, you know?
But we're not. And I think some people lose the factor of, like, nowadays, you're not having to push for those record sales because everybody's downloading everything.
Right.
Or if you are an Apple user, sorry, if you're Android, because we do Apple products.
Been using Samsung and Android products for all y'all shit. Anyway, so you ain't trying to hear that.
You been trying to hear that.
You see, look, that iPhone looks just like a what?
It looks like an iPhone.
No, it don't.
It's like an
iPhone.
Everything we record on, we use Apple products less.
Apple, we like an endorsement.
When Apple phone come out, that one's still fucking up. That's my question.
Right.
We're cutting you off the video. You're too dark.
Yeah. There you go. show him session tape. Do what?
Do this.
Come on.
Do this. Hey, smile for tears.
Come on, Blackie, smile.
No, but
anyway,
yeah, we're still
back on topic.
I know, we got
all the
but yeah, but can you compare it to old to the new? Can you even compare it?
Are you talking about just music styles? Yeah, or just like the artist
in general. Can you say that one is better than the other?
Yes. No, you can't.
What?
No, you can't.
Old school is better than
yes,
shit.
You can. I'm gonna say yes, listen, you can.
There wouldn't be new without the old, bro. When you think about it.
Right, there wouldn't be new without the old.
But what I mean by that is that something had to come from something.
That's what I'm saying.
Right. So old school hip hop had to come from something. Came from what? R&B and soul and shit.
Yeah, of course.
New rap had to come from old rap. I don't think you can necessarily say they're either better than something. To me, it's just, it evolves.
Yeah.
Just because that's just how it's.
They keep your phone on silent.
Yo, everybody got their phone on silent. Come on, man.
Come on, man. First of all, you were the latest one.
Yeah, you were the latest one.
And then you're going to have your phone on red.
Come on, man.
Get out.
Yeah, it's next.
So I got that big ass sweat on.
No. No, bro, you
about
to get
some
ass.
Let it go,
man.
Yeah, bro. Oh, man. As he walks off camera.
Come on, hold on. I'm here, man. Come
while
on,
he does that, I think it's going to go.
How are you just dingy in general?
That nigga a walking ash spot.
Hey. Damn, well, anyway, what you say that, man?
So what?
You were saying something, sir, before.
With the order.
No, I was just saying, like, to me, it's just shit evolves. Just like, just like people do.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Like, I'm not the same Lamar was. Shit, damn, he's been 5 years ago. You know, certain shit that would have made me snap 5 years ago, I can let that shit roll right now.
That's true.
You know what I'm saying? Like, just. I don't think
so. Then you say were you a better version then? Than you are now?
Exactly. That's the thing too.
Did you evolve? Did you evolve?
I see how your chick is like this. I see how
you evolved. I mean, I'm not.
No. Trust me. I feel what you're saying.
I feel what you're saying. Here's my thing. I feel what you're saying on that evolution thing. I think that, and I think everything must evolve. You know what I'm saying? If you don't evolve, then I think you die.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So you have to evolve. If hip hop wouldn't evolve, it would have died.
It'd be
what our parents used to say, oh, that junk ain't gonna last. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So it had to evolve because majority of the young people now probably couldn't feel what we listened to either.
No.
You know what I'm saying? Because it's on a whole different level. You know what I'm saying? When you think about the message, you know, that's not think about that. Okay.
I can say
that was revolutionary at the time.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because he was talking about the hood. He was talking about, you know, stuff that was going on, you know, and how he was outraged by it. You know what I'm saying? So the message was, that was revolutionary.
Totally different.
You know what I'm saying? I can feel that. But then now, people now, they probably couldn't feel the message. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? But go ahead.
Okay. Cream was gonna just say real quick, like, that you also did see, like, there's a shift too from that era.
Mm-hmm.
How you saying? He brought the message, and then once you see, like, other artists, like KRS-One, when they came out,
right?
They started off different. You feel me? They changed into this, like, whole anti-drug, mm-hmm. Because shit just started right there, the evolution.
Mm-hmm.
They started seeing things from a different perspective.
Right.
So, a different mindset, you're gonna start, you know, changing your music and all that shit.
I guess I'm sorry, go ahead and catch up.
You good, you got it.
I guess my biggest thing too is like, old thing about the new stuff is, I don't see that variety. And it could be because I'm looking at it from a biased perspective. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? When you think about, when I was coming up, I wanted to turn on some gangster rap, I had gangster rap.
Yeah,
I wanted to hear something talking about Pro Black, I had PE, you know, I had De La Soul, all the different groups. African Violet, I'm breaking monkey, breaking kids, but, you know what I'm saying?
I'm talking about the music.
But you know what I'm saying? You had different groups.
I cannot.
You got
got your little groups that you could fuck with. Right, like, Noi by Nature.
Yeah. It seemed like when I go on YouTube or I turn on the radio,
it's all sound
the same.
You know what sounds the same about itself though? The baby. The baby sounded exactly the same.
Listen, we were talking about that.
We literally just
Your mind's not great.
You weren't
on time.
Late
mind. You know what I mean?
Yeah. You're gonna be late to your own funeral, bro.
They gonna be still putting him in the casket while they putting it down. All right, let's throw him.
Your ass gonna hop in the casket while they trying to take you down the stairs and stuff. All right. Oh, I'm supposed to be in that motherfucker.
They dragging this nigga to church for us. Hold
up. Hey, the Paul Bears, I'm like,
please don't. If you are ever on this show, we will Jones you all the way.
Which
if
you are too bad.
Or if you say something dumb, just know. And that goes for if you put it in the comments as well. Just be prepared.
Yeah, you won't get roasted wrong.
Be prepared.
Oh, we know each other too.
Yeah, we know each other.
You know what I'm saying?
No, but yeah, the baby has the same exact flow with the same exact beat every song.
And that's pretty much what we was talking about earlier.
Because
I was telling him, and everybody else is like, I lived in Charlotte for 15 years. Mm-hmm. I didn't hear nothing about the baby. But then when I went to Jersey for a year, and I somehow just got put on. So I go through his catalog, I'm like, oh, this nigga hot.
Mm-hmm.
And then all of a sudden, his flame just exploded. And his last two albums, Kurt and Baby on Baby, is like they got maybe one or two songs that I could bop to. But other than that, I'm like, oh man, this sounds just like the rest of your catalog. I've heard that shit. Especially for me, it was new because I felt he was underground at that point. He didn't have that buzz. But now, he got like 6, 7, 8 songs on the top 100, and his flame is so huge. To me, it's like, it's just outgrown that mystique that I had it.
Right.
You
want to know what? I really found that sound that belonged to him.
Yeah,
he's like, oh, wow, I've got to capitalize off this.
But the only problem is with his style. It's not the motion
style. It's not at all. So, is it more now that people are trying to find that niche? And they just put that niche to make money.
But you know how niches happen.
Hold on, let me know how that niches happen. Yeah, because the idea is seem like,
the idea is like,
he was just hungry and they just wanted to kind of explore their crack.
You know what I'm saying?
Because, like, it seemed to me, like I said, I'm kind of biased. It seems to me like nowadays, more of the rappers now is about, I'm trying to get this quick lick. You know what I'm saying? It's a quick lick. So I get iced out, you know, drive some cars, you know, get the whole, and blah, blah, blah.
All systems come on with a hot beat and a hot look.
Let me get a hook. I don't even know what's going to
happen. You ain't even going to have a hook. All you gotta do is take one crazy line that we just said today and put it with a track and repeat it over and over again, and all of us about to be ready.
Hey, look,
we'll
be charged our rates off of saying simple words.
Yeah.
He said three simple ass elementary words. So look, but Lil Jon was part of my growing up, though.
Yeah,
right. Say what you want. Hey, that whole crunk phase, kind of to me, kind of helped usher the South into their own place. So say what you want about Lil Jon.
You say that, but people always deny Luke. People always deny Houston. You know, with Ghetto Boys, UGK.
Oh, yeah.
You know,
yeah, but you got to remember something. Like, you talked about Ghetto Boys, they kind of had a north feel to them.
I was gonna say, Ghetto Boys was definitely a more.
They had a more rugged kind of New York feel to them. So to me, you wouldn't have never known that they was from down south until they told you.
Okay.
You know Lil Jon from down south. Ain't no niggas from New York sound like him.
Yeah, you know. Okay.
Yeah.
But you this nigga from
Georgia.
And it's not
not to discredit some of the old cats and old hip hop that's from down south, putting it. But you can, just like you said, Outkast, to me, was never get they just do what. To me, shit, if you ain't got them on their Mount Rushmore in hip hop, you buddy. What's wrong with you? You know what I'm saying? So, hey, I'm glad you even brought them up because, hey, Andre 3000, that's a motherfucker. Hey, with Big Boy 2, hey.
Oh, yes.
And you can ask him too. That's what you're saying.
Go. From the start, you have to follow a certain path of a different artist in order to really find your own sound. Does that make sense?
Hell no.
No, it makes sense. Certain artists follow the path of other. Alright, so let's say I wanted to come up, right? The person I'm listening to the most right now, I'm gonna follow his flow until I find my own sound.
Okay.
You feel me?
Okay.
But why can't you just come out with your own sound? Be different.
But see, that's the thing. Everybody's trying to be different. You feel me? So with that,
they all end up sounding the same.
Exactly.
I didn't come in and start rapping with you, just come in and be like trying to rap like 50 or whatever. I just came in with my own flow.
Right.
You, when I heard you, nigga, you got your own flow. So it's like, as soon as it's just, you know, your own things, your own craft.
Exactly.
You feel me? Every artist do their own thing. Picasso ain't gonna fucking paint like Da Vinci.
Yeah, exactly, of course.
You can be inspired.
That's a fucking line.
These babies got some brains in them.
I'm gonna use that as a line real quick. That's what I'm gonna do.
Brain food.
But like y'all were saying, I don't mean to sound prejudiced, but like y'all were saying, people were starting to, once they find their own sound, they're constantly doing that same thing until they, you know what I mean? They're not going to find something different until they really branch off to other artists.
Right.
You know what I mean? So,
okay. Just from my understanding, are you saying like people are like hopping on the wave so they can get through it?
Exactly. That's what I'm saying.
In general, I understand what you're saying, because with anything, any craft, any art, you're gonna pattern yourself off somewhere.
Exactly.
To start.
Yeah.
You know, even with cooking, you know, that's my craft. One of them. But I'm just saying, you know, when I first started out, you know, for me it was more of the older people around me. You know what I'm saying? Grandma, great aunt, stuff like that. I watched what they did. I was like, you know, like so and so, like my mom did this. And I started patterning myself after that. And once I started learning more and getting more knowledge, then I started branching away from it. You know, I still had that foundation. Because that foundation, you know, where I stand on still, I still lean back to it. Even when I learned, you know, the five mother sauces, when I learned that, it's a good foundation to have, but I still incorporate what I learned from mom, because those things, they might not say just the five mother sauces, but they were still one.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? They're still doing some of the basic components to it.
Right.
You know, they still was degreasing of hand. You know, I mean, deglazing of hand. That's still deglazing of hand. They didn't say I'm deglazing of hand. I'm gonna add some wine. I'm gonna add, you know, some kind of stock to it, whatever. They knew they were gonna do that to deglaze the pan to make it more, you know, like flavor out of the pan. They knew that.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? They might have had the vocabulary to put with it and do what it was.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? Because it was passed down from generation to generation. And then you correlate that with rap.
Mm-hmm.
You go back to this genre we're talking about, you know, rappers do the same thing.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Nas and R. Kim are similar.
Yeah.
But are they the same? No. They're not the same.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But you know, Nas probably listened to R. Kim, which he said. You know, I listened to him, stuff like that. So he probably got inspired by him.
Hell, Nas influenced J. Cole.
You know,
right.
So yeah, what you said, I can agree with you on that. You're gonna kind of have that when you go pat yourself out to somebody, but look, if they successful, you know what I'm saying? If you're successful, why not pat yourself out like, until you can kind of find your way through, you know, where your own person is. You have an idea, but you know, you really don't know until you really start getting into what they're doing. So yeah, I kind of agree with that.
Yeah, that's like, where were you looking for, like, music evolve?
Yeah.
Because you know what to do now, you're just going to capitalize off of that, right. Come up with your own sound, make something different, not the same stuff over and over again.
Right.
Exactly. Yeah. Right. And I don't like that, but I was feeling what you were saying. Just come out with you.
Right, come out with you.
Because to me, I'm going to feel that a lot more.
Right, I'm going to feel that, especially if it's something that I'm going through and I can catch on to it with you, like, dang, that makes sense. It goes back to, I can tie an emotion to this. I can tie something to that. I think all of y'all just said something around the same point that I want to touch on it a little bit. This is going to be a little bit not political, but at the same time political. With the changing of people evolving and artists evolving and finding their sound. Let's touch on Kanye West.
Talk your shit.
God damn it.
When Kanye first came out, he was dope on his own. He came out with his own sounds.
Without question.
He came out with his own sound. Then life hit him. He went through whatever bipolar unnecessary stuff he went through.
Then he got married.
That's what I'm saying. He was there before
Kim.
He was there before that, and now he's hit that. Again, if there are any females that
want to
jump in.
We're talking tour here.
Come on, I'm a star.
I'm gonna come back into the government a little bit. I know this is cliche, but if you notice, right, almost 70% of America right now is Christian. Okay. Am I lying?
You might be a little more than that.
Yeah. I'm saying.
Yeah, we haven't changed the stats, but yeah, you get what you're saying, though.
Right. Okay, so around that, right, Christianity seems to be like the main religion right now.
Okay.
Although there's thousands more religions in the world. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? With how many of us on this planet? Like 70 billion of us? So I feel like, in a way, Kanye has talked with Trump before, right? As we know.
Mm-hmm.
Me, personally, I feel like it's like kind of a scheme. You know what I mean? I'm not saying Christianity is bad, but I'm saying it's a scheme to really warp our minds to be like, okay, maybe Christianity isn't as bad as I thought it was. Get all of the atheists back to, you know, start trying something different. You know what I mean? So,
so you think it's a business move, then?
Yeah. I'm not going to say a business move, but just a tactic, yeah. Like you said,
a business move as in, because let's be honest, you drive past a church in any city, and that motherfucker big as hell, they gonna pass a collection plate at least four or five times in a service. So by the time the end of the Sunday, they count money. So I think are you kind of saying Kanye is grabbing a point where he's trying to grab that religion money?
I'm grabbing the pocket. So let me try this. The whole world, right? In a sense, it's almost like a high school. The religions are the different groups.
Different cliques.
It clicks.
Yeah.
You got Islam, you got Muslim, I think it's the same.
Islam
is the beat. Buddhist, all
yeah,
different
yeah,
groups.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But people are trying to, I feel like the government is trying to captivate people more into the Christian field because the government is more Christian. I learned this in world history back in high school. Back then, when civilizations were starting,
the government came off Christian principles.
Yes.
Yeah.
And I feel like it's kind of just,
it's a ploy on that.
Exactly.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
But has anybody actually listened to that album?
I haven't heard it.
I heard it.
So I haven't heard it. So I'm
I'm not gonna lie. What is that song? God, Follow God. That's probably the best song on there, and it's not even involved around Christianity. It's more like he's rapping, and I'm like, it sounds like Kanye. It sounds like Kanye. I'll be honest.
So when y'all listen to the album, because when it came out, I got the alert when it came out, and I went ahead and downloaded it. So when I listened to the album, I literally skipped through all until I got to Follow God.
Yes, same here.
Because, now don't get me wrong, Kanye, by all means, do you. And like I said on last episode, you know, church is big for me. So I like the fact that you're taking someone from, without getting too churchy, from the secular world to bringing them to see something different. But at the same time, why are you losing yourself, or are you just now finding yourself? That goes back into that evolution. Whereas all that beforehand, when you first came out and you were given some of the dopest lines there were, to now to where you only have one song on the album that are like anywhere close to when he first came out. Because if y'all listen to God Follow, the lines that he drops on there are close to when he first came out.
Yeah.
Like his flow alone on there makes you just want to stop and be like, he didn't just say that. That's not what he just said. And rewind it and go, and it ties back emotion to the actual song.
You got to say.
I don't got shit to say.
You have to have something, because you about to I got to turn around for this one. Hold on.
Nah. He lost his fucking mind. That's it. I don't know where he went. He just lost his mind. I'm like, that's it, really. Whatever he's been dropping, shit. What was the album he dropped before the the one with the song Father Stretch My Hands? Like,
Life of Pablo.
I didn't hear that shit, because I was like, this nigga's already on some other shit.
But it's different, though. It's different.
But that goes back to what you were saying. Is it a plan for business wise, or is this really the new Kanye? Because if you think about it, going back to that same album, he was like, Yeezy is God. He was trying to get people to look at him as if he was God. So now you're going back to, okay, I can't get y'all to see me as Yeezy as God, so let me go ahead and get right. So now let me see if I go to the Christian realm, oh, then I can get them to follow what I'm saying.
Exactly.
So has he still lost his mind, or has he found his mind?
To me, I don't know.
Kanye has always been a very strategic, very calculated, very thought out individual when it comes to his music.
Yeah.
So to me, this God is, what, God is King? Is that what it's called?
Jesus. The album is called Jesus King.
Yeah, I haven't heard it, so I'm not gonna put my two cents on that shit, because I'm not gonna say anything, because to me it'd be ignorant to speak on something like that. I just think he's always been that type of person that it's a move that he has put so much thought into it. So to me, I'm kind of going where you're going. It might be a ploy, and kind of what you're saying, where he's always, to me, in his albums leading up to this one, he's always kind of felt like he was a rap god. Yeah. And his
ego.
Well, I just think his mindset of his talent is so godlike that this is just one thing that just have people grasp onto and just elevate himself.
But then
in his mind,
why do that? Because there's people who have godlike talent on the mic, and they still don't come out like, you gotta see me as this.
Right.
You feel me? So that's
why are you forcing his image?
I'm putting it to you this way.
That's why I'm like, he lost his mind.
To me, he's kind of building a persona like a wrestler.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Like, say you meet John Cena. John Cena, the wrestler, is not John Cena, the person. Because to me, I think what Kanye puts out on camera and the media is his wrestling persona.
Mm-hmm.
And that's, to me, is what gets people to, Kanye talk about him. Because to me, I don't think And I'm not knocking whatever his thoughts is with the government and all that shit. That's his thoughts. I mean, he's going to have his opinions just like everybody else. Right?
Yeah.
But when it comes to music, me personally, Kanye's a motherfucking beast. And I'm not taking in... I'm just basing outside of music. Because it don't affect me. But when it comes to this music,
that goes back to just what you said about him being strategic about how he does his stuff.
Yeah.
Strategic about his interviews that he does, about what songs he released. But then it goes back into him being, even though he's with a label, him being independent. Mm-hmm. Now he's gotten all his royalties and all of his stuff to where he's independent. But why the change now?
To me, it's a strategic move.
It is.
But I think it's just that business. Just business.
I have to agree because if I find it, I'll post it on our Facebook page for you guys to see, and you guys can like and put your comments underneath. But there's an interview that he did with just one guy. They're up in the mountains, and. That interview was so strategic on. You literally watch the interview and you watch his pauses before he answers the question.
Yeah.
And when I say the pauses, I mean he can have a conversation like I'm doing now, and then he's.
And then those, you know.
That's weird.
You're talking fucking weird ass person.
I'm serious. The pauses, am I lying? The pauses go that freaking long.
Yeah, I think about it.
But because I think he's trying to strategically.
Exactly.
Give the right answer and not come off as a motherfucking flip flop.
Exactly.
But it shows.
Can backfire.
But exactly. It shows him back in that when I watch the interview, it goes back to me thinking, like you said, he done lost his mind.
Yeah, but
and
you,
I'm all,
but you
I'm
know
all
everybody got that friend that play crazy.
But listen,
that's smart as hell.
There's a lot of.
He's just retarded.
I'm about to say, put your hand out. I just mentioned a name, and I'm going to take it right now. I'm going to put it down.
They're not serious.
No, we're serious.
You might be able to claim disability, but
what I'm saying, there's a lot of throughout history, there's a lot of people who are highly intelligent and has some kind of psychosis.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not saying that both cannot be the same.
Yeah.
He can be highly intelligent, he can be intelligent, he can be strategic, and has some kind of psychosis going on there.
Eminem, you know what I'm saying? A great example.
So it can be coming in and out, in and out, in and out, in and out.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm not saying that he cannot still be, crazy is not a clinical term. For lack of a better word, say
mentally
he crazy.
Ill.
He could be mentally ill, some kind of psychosis going on. I look at some of the stuff he does. Now he already said he's bipolar. So I already know that's there.
Yeah, that's
okay, so that's gonna play a part in some of the things he do too.
Yeah.
When I look at the
he got two people in his head.
Yeah, right.
At least. Let's start with that.
At least two.
We got Kanye and we got Yeezy.
Kanye and Yeezy and whoever this is doing.
When I look at some like the religious stuff, you know, and I look at it from a different standpoint because, you know, I was in a church for so long. So when I watch the services, I'm looking at like, this is not church. This is a concert.
Yeah, exactly.
This is a concert where at the end, he speaks a few words. He doesn't preach.
He just says
he doesn't really.
It's like giving remarks.
He don't even read a lot of scripture.
But maybe is that his style of preaching?
Let me get to that. Because there are different styles.
Okay.
But there is one continuum throughout any type of style of preaching that you do use the word. And he doesn't do that.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
But he does a little bit more now. Because I think someone actually challenged him on that when mm-hmm. he first came out. Because a lot of the church was ridiculing him for that. And he started coming out more. You saw more of his next shows or church services. Mm-hmm. With him having his Bible, mm-hmm. all of a sudden, and actually going, trying, or not trying, but using the word. Mm-hmm. But then again, without getting too Christian or too churchy, the devil knows the Bible too.
Yeah, mm-hmm. true.
So
talk your shit.
Who are we really doing? Because when I saw it, mm-hmm. And it's
the devil is angel too.
Listen, yeah, until he got kicked out, and I'm heavily in the church now. I'm heavily in my faith now. And when I saw it, the first thing for me was I don't want to go to church and hear a Leo one in a million with gospel lyrics. Now, that's just my preference. Mm-hmm. Because if I'm trying to, quote unquote, get my life together and be solely just for God, why am I going to backside of hearing my R&B stuff if I am choosing, because it's all a choice, if I'm choosing not to listen to it? Yep. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, I love the fact that he's crossing those bridges, but Nicki Minaj crossed that bridge when she did a song with, I can't even think of her name, not Tasha, was it Tasha? It was with Tasha Cobbs.
Okay.
She did a song with Tasha Cobbs. She didn't change who she was. She didn't do anything that she came on a gospel artist track and spit gospel bars that were killer. But she didn't change and make no showcase out of it like Kanye's doing.
Jesus.
Is that the wind?
Yeah. Told you that the wind, man.
See, Howard.
Yeah, he got some ghosts in his motherfucker.
But, we're going on an hour. Go ahead and start rapping.
Oh, yes, Lord.
But, I guess. I can't make say that you can compare it to. You know what I'm saying? Going back to like whether or not old to new.
Okay.
Because I think that the evolution, like we said before, that's the best way to describe it. It evolved into what it is.
Of course. Okay. Yeah.
And I think that's a natural progression that should happen anyway with anything. I think the argument to try to say that it's worse off, it's kind of hard for me to make now, and I used to say it. I used to say it all the time. It's garbage now.
You know what I'm saying? I still say it.
But I think that I'm saying that from a 40-year-old perspective. You know what I'm saying? Because the music's not for me. It's not made for me. So then my perspective is going to be different. So I'm really on the outside looking in.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because I'm not a part of that culture anymore.
Well, you're not part of that target audience.
That target audience.
Yeah, that's right.
You know, say anymore.
Yeah.
So, for me to say, okay, it's garbage, then that's me not really looking at it from a perspective of I shouldn't, it's not for me anyway. You know, now that if I think from that mindset, I can say, okay, maybe it's not garbage, it's just not my cup of tea.
So then that's my thing, since you talking about like target audiences,
mm-hmm.
kind of want to bring in this nigga real quick, Snitch 9.
We were supposed to talk about that.
We're gonna talk about that, and then we're gonna wrap it up because we gotta hit that topic. That we gotta get.
He is garbage.
Trash, hot, garbage. Right. That's French. I don't know if that's French.
Some of the beats are hot.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
When I started hearing a nigga voice, I was like, but I couldn't play that mess in my car.
First of all, his voice doesn't match his body.
I'm a nigga,
nigga. That's the, right. Just like that. First of all, his voice doesn't match his body. And I don't understand. I don't understand half of it. He sounds like, right, a Muppet Baby. I don't understand half the crap he's saying. He's a bubble gum rapper.
Yes, gumbo.
No, gumbo has flavor. He doesn't.
Yeah.
Gumbo has. I'm talking about. He is that. He's that bubble
chicken,
chew.
He's that chicken salad with the raisins in it.
No, he's that. He's that bubble chew artist. The one you, the gum you put in your mouth by the 2 seconds is gone. Like
juicy fruit.
Right. Yeah. He catches you with the beat, and then as soon as he opens his mouth, I'm like, all right.
I'm done.
Just like that. Just like that. Straight pause. I'm not doing it. Not at all.
He's an industry plant. He's an industry plant. That's what he is. That's all he is.
I think
you
are. Huh?
Can we get into that? Industry plants.
Oh, okay, let's do this.
Wait.
Yeah, let's
I see this is going to be a part two to this.
No. I'll chop it up. Go ahead, say what you're going to say.
No, I mean, like you said, these industry plants out here, that's a real thing. You know what I mean? That is a real thing.
What, yeah, people should treat you lead drop and target certain things?
Of course, it's called marketing.
Yeah.
Dumb car marketing.
Yeah. It's called, I do it for a living. It's called marketing.
Yeah,
of course. Yeah, but who picked that nigga?
First of all, you gotta think about it. Just when he came out with his appearance alone, When I first saw a picture of him, hadn't even heard any of his music. I saw a picture of him with that ugly behind rainbow hair, that ugly behind face tattoo. Yeah. And I was like, you are here for a marketing plan only to get someone to listen to whatever label you're with to bring them in. Then you're going to drop the next artist that actually has talent. You can't, that's all it is. Marketing 101, you put out something that's going to draw them in, and then you give them with all the knowledge and stuff that goes with it.
If you think about it like this, you see his album, or whatever, we don't even go to stores and buy them anymore, but you see his picture somewhere, and you like, I gotta see what this crap even look like. What kind of music will he even play? And you go to play it. You know what I'm saying? You listen to it. Now, some people are not into lyrics. Some people just like to hear the beat.
They just want
to
hear that.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So they be like, oh, I could bop to this. I got a nice little beat. And they'll play it. And then they see, you know, a lot of people playing it, and the sales go up. So he accomplished what he needed to do. You know what I'm saying? I sold so many records.
He probably was there just for one reason.
I got that money.
His wife snitched, so he can go up.
But he's not really part of the culture.
No, you know what I'm saying? So he could never be a part of the culture.
It's so easy for him once he got caught to start saying, oh, it was that nigga. Then he started bringing up people that ain't wanting to involve this nigga, that nigga. You know what I'm saying? Because he's not part of that culture. He don't understand that culture. You know, you think about us. You know what I'm saying? No, growing up, I ran the streets a little bit. Some of that stuff's still in me. So, like, it's certain things I'm just not going to do because it's just ingrained in me.
First one,
it's snitching,
it goes to that shit.
You know what I'm saying? So, you know, certain things, it's funny because it's an automatic thing. Like, somebody might say something like, we be at work and something happened, and you'd be like, who did that? Like, no.
Shit, I don't know.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? I ain't seen nothing, bro. You know what I'm saying? It's an automatic thing.
Yeah.
Because it's something that we was raised in.
Yeah.
So someone like him who wasn't raised in that, so it's like, hey, who was it? Oh, these niggas over there.
He did it.
You know what I'm saying? It's easy because he's not part of that culture.
Now, that nigga was looking like goddamn First 48. Right. Call your mama. Oh, you don't call my father. I mean, yeah, it ain't nigga nothing. Yeah, man, that changes everything. Yellow Capri's and everything.
But the just started facing my
You know, once a nigga get a cigarette, it's a wrap.
So it's like, if you're talking about purity,
can I get a cigarette?
You're talking about purity to him. Because a lot of us, for me, you know what I'm saying? I went away from it for a while because I'm like heavy off in the church. So there's some years that I don't know a lot about. You know, like Phoebe breaks up, I'm like, I don't know about that. I had to go online and research it. But like the time when I was just really, really into it, I was pure hip hop.
Yeah.
The purity of it. You know, I love the whole thing about hip hop. And so, you know, when you get people like him to come in and I can't get with him because it's like,
It's like you're making a mockery of something I like, something I love, something I'm with,
some of the culture that I grew up with. You know what I'm saying? So I think that's the problem with people like him. You know, I don't have a problem with, it's not about his, you know, him being Mexican, I had nothing to do with it. Ain't got a really problem with his purple hair or rainbow hair, whatever the hell it is. And it's not really about the hair because we all have our, I say it's about everybody. We all have our quirks and weirdness to us. You know what I'm saying? And some of us choose to do let it come out. Some of us don't hide it. Whatever, it's there. So if he, because that's his thing, that doesn't bother me. But it was just something about him. You could see him say, he not real to this.
No, of course.
You know what I'm saying? It was all a money grab. Yeah, it's all about.
Of course.
So anyway, we're going to let everybody say one last thing but close it out and start this way. Go ahead, Lamar.
Shit, man, I'm just happy to see just different types of individuals still. We all got the same appreciation for hip hop and rap. So, Tyrant evolves, it is what it is, it's just gonna happen.
Right.
Just as long as, you know, there will still be artists that we can all emotionally relate to. As long as that happens, I'm cool with it.
Right.
But, I mean, to me, hip hop is not just a genre; it's a culture.
And
y'all see how we got culture brunches every day that's been still jacking fucking shit.
Right.
So, I mean, hip hop's just a true representation of our culture. And to me, it's like it sometimes tells a little piece of me.
Right.
You know.
Look. Your favorite rapper is full of shit. Everything that he's ever said is from a script. Everything you were ever fed is from the lips of dudes who don't believe in the principles that you've come to grip. So now let's modify that. Modernize rap to personify facts. Instead of a face tat, go study some face raps. Brad Jordan is more important than Spotify stats. Niggas faking they streams anyway. Buying numbers, the number you are, they can penetrate. And plant seeds, a man's deeds is worth more. Can't breathe, I stampede the church door. Can't see myself following false doctrine. I'm Ice Cube Cube, but there's no style that I'm boxed in. I get offended when niggas say that I'm top 10. Bitch, you get assaulted behind bars when I rock hymns. ASAP 2020 rock him. To the common industry tendencies, I would not bend. I would not flinch for a second. Check the opticals. Either you're a bridge or an obstacle. You see, I can give it to you, but what you gonna do with it? We created a style that most of you mimic. I'm less Kirk Franklin, more Langston Hughes with it. New Kimmich, still refusing the use of your eugenics. Too timid to approach me in real life, so you hide behind your keyboards. Your career is a permanent detour. I distort the view of your accolades and rewards. Reassure is pure when I record. I'm reborn on every beat that I reach for. When I breach your status quo won't static, no, you rather leech more. That's the reason these niggas create the fake beef for, so you can click the link and they can eat more. You see, rappers on the bubble find other rappers to make trouble. Premeditate feuds and fan bases double. All at the expense of the listener, y'all ignore me. And you wonder why real niggas look at you as corny. Your coronation don't coincide with the corner store. The corridor to the coroner is the course you on. Of course you on, you a stereotype. A caricature of America's imperial plight. This is serious material, cause every empirical image of niggas is seen in a satirical light. Either overly violent or you hypersexualized. If you've never been oppressed, then it's hard to contextualize. If you never seen the truth, then it's hard to reject a lie. Dangerous is the claims in an affidavit. Dangerous is the blade from decapitation of religious cults handling snakes in the Appalachians. Witness the scope of his parameters. You can't cover these bullet wounds with bandages. We won't fight for our people with disadvantages, but camp overnight for Jordans and chicken sandwiches. Jeez. Don't become a statistic, cause you can get shot whether or not you even reach for a biscuit. What? The system that we in is sadistic. Until you kick the bucket and you covered in flour, then you enlisted. Listen to the lyrics that linger out of my language. Private owned prisons is generational anguish. This is all part of a larger plan they came with. They will force your hand till you fold and cave in. Cave drawings inside of a catacombs, or scattered bones of rappers inside of a mausoleum. That's just how I look at the artists that y'all be deeming. As a second coming, I'm coming to spark carpe diem. When niggas say facts, I think fiction. Rumors and allegations are just as bad as convictions. Social media mediates every decision, cause we scared to take a stand in the court of public opinion. Black icons are now pawns inside the plot. Racists on trial, you in denial or you not?
That's right.
Not to say I conveyed was flagrant, but some of our spokespeople ain't nothing but double agents. Oh. I am the Denmark Vesey to Plessy Ferguson. Every verse I'm him is necessary but burdensome. An onerous, you diss at your own risk. If you speak my name in vain and you slit in your own wrist, it's about Jeez. Ownership. Who was ownership? I was ownership. I was trying to focus on getting noticed to coexist. Your coping method ain't copaesthetic, go rope a medic. You spoke a verse, but we know who did it. You're so pathetic. You go on Reddit and readily try to mock me. Aki, you waiting on the Mardi Gras. I'm waiting on the Mocky. Your Motley Crue is a crusade of incels. I am the audio equivalent of a chemtrail. All well and ends well. The ends justify the means. Your meaningless mockery will land you incels. In celebration of finally finding patience, I'm placing my own bias to the side to gather intel. Nigga, I will slay y'all kings. Leave your bitch wide open like Draymond Green. Leave your click side coping today. Say I mean, a stock for the law. Don't ever underplay my dean. Whatever I say I mean, I believe that I was chosen. Plucked from the fruit of the tree that you beholden. Emboldened by faith, my father gave divinity. Fuck status quo, no record label can limit me. Every rap is calligraphy, every act has been clinically diagnosed as soul. So why take offense to these bitch niggas that you choose to celebrate? Till they lose steam, then you scheme to separate. Set the date and I meet it, accelerate through anemic. Niggas claiming they got you, but never there when you need them. Begging for me to lead them, I leave them all at wayside. I take pride, exposing when niggas can't hide. I take sides when niggas aim at my family. Let them dwell in hell, the heavens is my canopy. Your ghostwriter's full of estrogen. You let him rewrite your life like Paul in the New Testament. Set me next to his Mexican, I will X him, then exit when niggas say that I'm done, but homie, that is never been. I'm never bent off bullshit, I use it to fertilize my dreams. You scream, but it's useless. Look, I'm the byproduct of prophecy. The foreshadow of force travel from my apathy. The quite opposite of what's opulent. Every occupant inside your purview deters you from what you strive to get. I'm considering littering little nuggets of information to give niggas some game before they reach the pavement. The pay stubs that you stubbornly waste will eventually bite the ass of those spinning with haste. See, there's a difference between a player and a coach, a boss and a roach, a sheep and a goat. The anchor's been severed, still we sink with the boat. So they don't have to tie the noose, they let us reach for the rope. You come across weakened and you sing when you spoke. Still have to promote an image I perceive as a hoax. Every time you underachieve, you concede or you gloat. Two extremes we don't need to invoke. I'm vocally outspoken, still I know what was took. The paradigm is paralyzed, parasites are afoot. Trying to hide behind the beat, their disguise is the hook. Your discography's a mask, still a masses partook. Look, I expect that type of clash. Heard he dropped a new track. I respect the right to pass. You believe your future's bright, but neglect the right to pass. How you spray yourself with Axe, but forget to wipe your ass. No. See?